And welcome everyone here in Twitch chat and everybody on YouTube for our first deck with the new set that is out. We have Bilgewater as a new region. It's the Rising Tides set. And so we got some new decks to play. So we have four new decks that we're playing today. Two of them are built around basically a whole bunch of Rising Tides cards. We got Scout Midrange and Deep Sea Monsters. Both of those have two new champions, which this one, we got Misfortune and Quinn. And we're going to be really testing out the Scout ability. I'll talk about that here in just a second. The other two decks that we're going to be playing are basically older decks with only just a few new cards, just a couple of new cards in them. And that's going to be the Sewanee Frostbite, basically taking the Frostbite midrange and putting in Sewanee. And then Demacia Sacrifice, trying out some new Shadow Isles tools. But first, yeah, we're gonna be seeing how much we can attack. We're gonna be trying to attack and attack often with our new Scout ability. So what Scout is that the first time only Scout units attack each round, ready your attack. So if you only attack with just creatures with Scout, then you basically get to attack again. Then it's like you get to rally. So you can have two attacks a turn. And that's important because Quinn's level up is when, Quinn, of course, has Scout and summons a Valor that also has Scout. And then the level up is whenever I've seen you attack four times. And Misfortune's leveled up also when I've seen you attack four times. So we're putting these together and trying to have our champions in play and attack four times. And then, profit from our leveled up champions that are both going to be pretty strong. And Misfortune's ability to do a lot of damage to our opponent's battling enemies and their enemy nexus. Our top end, we have some more scout creatures. The Elmheart gives all of our other allies +1/+1 this round whenever we play it. And Citrus Courier, we can play this and heal our allies and our nexus 3 if we have already attacked and dealt damage. So that's what the plunder trigger is. A whole bunch of new stuff in here, let's give it a try. All right, so I believe ranked isn't working right now. Okay, yeah, actually, there, that makes sense. So we're just gonna be playing our normal matches. That's all good. Ranked should be working tomorrow. It's just kind of down right now, under maintenance. Ooh. Playing against Twisted Fate. First time. Alright, let's get rid of the 6 drop. Do I want to get rid of Quinn also? Kinda wanna keep Quinn. Grizzled Ranger looks like one of the best cards from the set. We're gonna be putting this in our Demacia Sacrifice deck later on also. Yes, I love this music. Demacia board's already my favorite. We got the Powder Monkey. Got new stuff, new board. New companion.
I'm one of the good guys.
We got some new emotes. No, don't kill Misfortune.
Hell of a day.
All right, a bunch of island navigators.
All right, let's mess some folks up.
Let's go with the Grizzled Ranger. The tussles pretty well with that. Chump Womp.
Nothing gets between me and my mark.
Hot damn is the boss. You best start running.
Let's go, Quinn.
I'm always up for a round or two.
Alright, so they're going red card. Deal 1 to all enemies and the enemy nexus. Let's have the 4-1 fight the 4-3 first. It's gonna die to this one damage. No! Well, dang, that was not a very good turn for me. That was a really good turn for them. I mean, I guess we just trade Loyal Badger Bear for Chump Wump. I do have another Quinn, so it's a 3-2 now, so trading it with the 4-3 isn't so bad. Okay, so they're just trading with the Twisted Fate. And because I want to make this trade because then it'll make it easier for my 2-4s to attack through.
The ocean charts our course.
Draven's biggest fan. Oh, I didn't check. So Ezreal now has 6. So yeah, does that thing that does 3 damage like to us? I think that leveled up Ezreal 3 times. Which, if so, is completely broken. I wish I could double spell. Okay, it puts like a target string when you play it. Yeah, they need to patch that. That needs to change. Like, that should not level up Ezreal 3 times. Yeah, that is insane. That should not be a thing.
Follow my lead. I've got your back.
I have those cards. It's not the worst. Okay, we could use a spell.
find our enemies wherever they hide.
Never lost a I really like the music on this board too, I agree. Those Twisted Fates have been so good. That card's really good too. That new removal spell. That pairs really well with Ezreal. So just have the two cards left besides these mushroom clouds. I have two cards, but they're not very good if we're not doing damage to them. Hey, legendary wizard. Hello. Twisted Fate's been out for two cards.
Charmed, I'm sure.
I was definitely hoping they wouldn't block. And we would get Plunder turned on. Should be lethal. Opponent's deck looked good. Wait, what is this? No, I shouldn't have crafted these other cards first. Oh no, triple... Oh, I should not have crafted these other cards first. Ouch. Okay, so I guess... Okay, well that's awesome. Get a Sewani champion card. Oh no, I already have... I had two Sewanis already. So it's saying that I just have like all... You know, enough for all of this. That's pretty great. All right, got a Gangplank. I guess we got enough experience for all these region rewards. Dude, we are definitely using the Shadow Owl card back today. Change region. Huh. So I guess, yeah, it says we have enough here. Oh man, I could have had another Elmheart. Any other regions that we have more than 20? Wait, Bilgewater? I'm already maxed out on Bilgewater? What? Hey, Blade! Thanks for the gifted sub. What's up, TV? C'est la vie? TV, c'est la vie. Welcome to the channel. I don't know. Does y'all say this? Says I'm already filled up. Like, is it backlogging, like, all the experience that I gained since after filling up all the rest? Like, maybe that's why, just like all the experience that we gained since the last time, like since they were filled before. Okay, got an epic card. Yeah, I definitely seems like it's a bug. I wish I wouldn't have crafted, like, I crafted these four decks before starting, and now I wish I didn't craft those four decks. Get a fizz. Nope, another Gangplank. We're going to play some Gangplank decks. Now we got two. Oh, on the initial home screen, it says that these are bugged. Oh, I hope that doesn't mean... Cool, some Sheriff Letter as Rose. I hope that doesn't mean that I don't actually get any of these cards in my account. I know, this is... Yeah, greatest bug ever. Alright. Epic card. Alright, so that's the third Sheriff Lariat Rose, or Larietta Rose, or however that's pronounced. More commons. Oh, should not have crafted anything. The Siren. Yeah, maybe that's the bug, is that they just see all the experience that I had before. I don't know. Whoa, double champion! Double champion, champion capsule. There's the third Gangplank and our first fizz. Ooh, epic capsule, got a champion. Got another fizz. There we go. Well, this helps. This definitely helps, you know, crafting the rest of the cards and stuff. This is nice. This got upgraded to a diamond chest. I think it got upgraded. I don't know. Maybe it was a diamond chest to begin with. Yeah. What a twist of fate. Champion wild card. Take that. Plunder Poros. Some more commons. It's really the rares I want. There's so many rares. I don't have rare wild cards. I have a ton of common wild cards, but I don't have any rare wild cards. I have zero. I have to craft rares with shards. Get that Bilgewater card back. Are we going to be the first person using the Bilgewater card back? We're about to put that on this Scout Midrange deck. Oh. upgraded champion wildcard. Okay, you already saw somebody else with the Bilgewater card back. Okay. All right, well, there we go. Whoa! What is this, Riot Games? Coming on in here, gifting out a whole bunch of subs. What is up? Everybody get a whole bunch of hype in the chat. Wow. What's it? Hey, Storm. Wow. All right, we gotta change our card back. Gotta use Bilgewater. That is awesome. The Riot Games. Coming here, we're gonna get a whole bunch of hype boats in here. So that's gonna be, you know, that's enough sub goals. That's enough sub goals for a 12-hour stream right there. Yeah. Oh, thank you. Thank you. All right, I feel like we need a 12-hour Legends of Runeterra stream this weekend. The new cards are great so far, except for how Ezreal triggers three times off of the card that does one damage to three random things. That wrecked us up, and that feels like that should not happen. Besides that, everything else is great. We got our monkey, we got our Bilgewater board. I love the music in the Bilgewater board. That was 30 gifted subs, so we're gonna have a bunch of hype boat. We're going through here 30 times. Oh man, I love this music on this board. Oh, emote meta is important. We're going with three of the other ones that we've done before. I got like the positive, good job. We have some challenger, so we got the come at me for the challenger, and then we got the new thinking emote. Ooh, I like this Maokai Nautilus Elise. I like this. That sounds sweet. I'm gonna kind of just keep this, see what happens. We don't have that many spells in the deck, so like the spells do have a higher priority because we don't have very many in the deck. Thank you so much, Riot Games. Again, definitely made our day. The Thorny Toad. I think I just pass instead of using the Bright Steel Protector. I think we need to get some more value out of that Bright Steel Protector. No, probably not Blade. Probably not. All right, so that's it. So we're doing a 12-hour stream on Saturday for that hype from Riot Games. I'm going to be putting it down in the description underneath the 12-hour stream. Hey, Skya, thanks for the raid. So we got new set, new cards, 12-hour stream on Saturday. And the raid. Nice, Skya, you got it. A sub gifted by the Riot Games. Dude, right? Isn't this Bilgewater music amazing? That's like my favorite thing. Abyssal Eye is pretty sweet. They're about to hit me for three and draw a card. card is pretty sweet.
Alright, let's mess some folks up.
Let's mess some folks up. I don't think we can let that happen, right, Powder Monkey? No. Yeah, the deep keyword means that once you have 15 or less cards in your library, then the unit that has deep gets +3/+3. Hmm. So I kind of want to see if they play something. Okay, so they get to draw a 3 or less cost card. So I want to play this hired gun.
Success gets noticed around here.
So that's why I wanted a double spell. That's why I didn't play the Razor Scale Hunter. That is a cool combo, the Zap Spray Fin with the Lure of the Depths. That is a good combo. Alright, we'll have you, and you attack. You pull the 1/2. Oh wait, oh this is the thing with that's fine, still you. I know, right? So many new decks and not enough shards. Right. That's why I have two like brand new decks with the Scout and the Deep Sea Monster, so we have like two decks like with all the new cards. And then we're playing two decks with just only a couple new cards, the Sewanee Frostbite and the Demacia Sacrifice. Both those decks only have just a very small amount of new cards. So, you know, like, it'll be easier for people to have, like, a lot of the old cards. Demacia Sacrifice is, you know, Lucian and Callista with the new Shadow Isles 3-drop. Your debit shard. Gotta use that debit shard. Alright, they're tossing. So I feel pretty confident that we are going to be attacking for lethal this turn. Well, I guess, let's see. 4, 8, 9, 10, 11. Yeah. So we'll see if they have removal or not. Because we can just attack with this, and then these two. And we'll have this pull here. And that gets a good amount of removal in. Yeah. We have a riposte for protection. Awesome. Yeah, we are going to be playing some Maokai, the Deep Sea Monster deck. I'm playing 3 Maokai. Yep. And, you know, good chance that we're going to play a 5th deck. I kind of, like, waited for more people to get on in here and see what y'all want to build and stuff. And, you know, so I'm kind of planning on a 5th deck also for today. This up here. Also, let's write this down. 12-hour stream. On Saturday. We'll have ranked Tino available then. We'll be ranking up. I love this Ranger's Resolve card, by the way. I think this card can be really good. Like, this would have been a great card to have against that Ezreal deck that we played against. Let's see. But I think we can ship it now. Gangplank and Swain. Alright, well, I do have Gangplanks now. So we're good there. And I do like Swain because I like Noxus. Yeah, feel free. If you have a list that you like, c'est la vie, feel free to post that in chat, and we can play some Gangplank and Swain later. This is awkward how I didn't draw anything that cost one or two. Got an awkward hand, and no spells to use for the spell mana. Alright, let's get Misfortune out ASAP. Love it. That's our first Misfortune trigger. So Swain, Noxus, Keg, steal opponent's cards. Okay. I like it. Yeah, Marpaletti, if you got a list you want me to play, send, you know. This is the time for, definitely the time for experimentation and everything. Down to 11. What do we got? Shell Shocker. We already have all the spell mana we need. Make it rain. I should have the overlay up. Maybe the overlay is just not working with the new cards. I would honestly be surprised if the overlay was working with the new cards already. Honestly. Thanks, Marpaletti. Oh, it is working? Okay, that's good to know. I just want to throw this thing out there. Not really. Maybe I do. Maybe I do. If they want to block with their 1/4, it turns into a 1/1 because of the Misfortune trigger and the spell and the Shell Shocker. No! Alright, so that's going to obliterate an enemy with less health than me. It has to be less than, right? It's not less than or equal to. Ah, that's a fast build speed anyway. Alright, well, let's use this. Alright, so you fight there. This is just too risky as fast spell. It's not burst where we know where we can do this first and then see. And that thing's ephemeral. How do I want to make this attack?
I demand satisfaction.
Because basically I want to get another attack in, and now Citrus Courier. Which, I was going to heal my ally 3. I should have just taken the Wanderer. Alright, so now we're going to attack, level up Misfortune.
Fresh out of mercy. Then.
This is pretty busted. We had three attacks this turn. Scout attack, regular attack, courier, rally attack. All with misfortune in play. So that does one damage to the battling allies three times, and so like those, or enemies, not allies. So like the 3-2, hey, what's up, Conti? You know, those 3-2s just died. I probably should have killed Maokai, shouldn't I? I just forgot this was a champion. Like, this doesn't even, like, it doesn't have, like, a... It doesn't seem like it has the champion border, right? I kind of forgot that this was actually Maokai. I was just thinking it was, like, a regular 1-4 that, like, did something else. It doesn't really look like a champion, does it? It doesn't have, like, the you know, like, this has a champion border. Yeah, sneaky Maokai. I don't know, should we make it rain? We could make it rain. Yeah, let's make it rain. Let's see if we kill this Maokai by making it rain. That's good. Pretty good.
Who will do not doubt?
And so life eternal.
Yep, there you go, Bob Fish. You got your tie. Alright, don't really need...
I'll hunt them where they breed. And so, life springs anew! You call this a fight?
Don't really need the rest of the deck. That's gonna do three, and then all three of these things were lethal. Alright, well that was pretty awesome with Misfortune and with the Courier getting those three attacks. That was pretty awesome. Hey Yud! Hope you had a good busy day. I was thinking Yasuo plus Swain. Yasuo deals non-combat damage, so evolve Swain. That is correct. Yep. Yeah. Yeah, if you stun, you know, if you get Yasuo triggers and Yasuo gets to do damage, it's not combat damage. Let's keep this. This is probably a deck that's playing Withering Whale. They're probably going to be trying to Withering Whale me, and so we have like a one mana counter to Withering Whale, which I'm all about.
I'm one of the good guys, but not that.
All right, well, the problem is Misfortune won't be tough anymore. It's just it's a one-turn thing. But it's still worth it to spend one mana and keep the champion in play. Yeah, J-Tizzle. I've been playing this new game, Legends of Runeterra, instead. Alright, get him, Ranger. Ranger's got Scout, so we can go straight to attacks with the Ranger. You can't do that. Alright, attacked a little fast. I was excited. That kind of makes me think Callista. It makes me think that they're going to be playing Callista. Oh wait, they don't even have Callista in their deck. What am I they don't even have Callista in their deck. Anyway, I guess I just don't have a good attack, right? I can't attack. I guess I could have played this Hunter, but... I don't want them to draw two. Nah. Okay, never mind. No, we'll let them draw two. Dang. Drawn too many. These spiders. Their pride will cost them. When I saw this game for the first time, I'm like, I'm not gonna spend money on this. Now I'm like, Bilgewater board, need it. Bilgewater board is awesome. I have to fight through a lot of these spiders. This is gonna be kind of tough. You know what we could use? We could use a Quinn. Or a Misfortune. I guess really what we need is Misfortune. Right, so kind of playing this game out. I wish I didn't play the Misfortune on turn 3, because, yeah, Misfortune would have been really valuable for all these spiders and everything later on. Barrier? Question mark? Yeah, I think so, folks. I think so.
I'll stop you.
Yeah, I have good faith in this game becoming popular. I think it's just a really, really well-made game, and ouch. Good dog. And the people at Riot know what they're doing. You know, we're about to have mobile. That's going to be huge. And now, then all we need is like really a good competitive scene and like and even just like tournaments or events on the program that are easy to join. That's the next up. I guess I shouldn't be attacking with these two, should I? I guess I should just be attacking with the two. Should only be attacking with the... Oh, yep, mobile's already out for you? Okay, I just checked earlier today, and I didn't see mobile earlier today for iPhone.
I know what lurks in the shadows. Their pride will cost them.
You have the game mobile already? Okay. That is great. That is great news. Quinn. So I kind of messed that turn up. I should have just attacked with the two scouts first. I could have gotten an extra attack, basically, if I would have done that. Well, I hope they don't have atrocity.
Still heart steady aim.
Is this worth doing this? What's up, Nimble Poro? Get him. Oh no, they got two things also. Alright, pull you over here. That kills my Quinn. That was a good card to play. So let's say they block the Quinn. I do six. Yeah, it's worth it. All right, so I messed this game up a few different places, but that was a really good learning game, honestly. Like with the new scouts and everything. One, I shouldn't have played. So, you know, like that one of those last attacks, I should have just attacked with the two scouts. I could have got that extra attack in, which probably would have won me the game. But I really should not have played Misfortune on turn three. That's kind of a good thing to kind of learn against, like spider decks, which obviously we knew they were a spider deck. They had Elise. Don't just play the Misfortune on turn three. Wait for them to have a board full of spiders before dropping Misfortune, where you can play it, attack, and clear up the blockers and everything. So I had a couple mistakes in there. I don't know what I want to do against Swain's Sewani. I guess I just keep this stuff. I do wish our deck had more ones and twos. We are pretty slow. It's a deck built on all like 3, 4, 5.
War Mason, reporting for duty.
Yeah, I could definitely see that, playing Prismatic Barrier instead of Riposte, so that on turn three we can protect Misfortune. I can absolutely see that. Okay, so the Demolitionist did not target itself. that was something that we had questions about before, because, you know, it just says deal one to an ally, and it is an ally, so we weren't sure if it doesn't say like another ally. So whenever we're doing the review yesterday, we weren't sure if it was going to be able to just do, like, if it did one to itself or not. But it looks like the answer is no, it does not do one to itself. Yeah, there you go. People in chat are hopefully helping you out. What do we got here? Wolf Rider? Man, that card is so good. Actually, no, I'll just send this thing in here. I wasn't planning on attacking with that, but I guess I'll just send it in there and get another attack. So I didn't need to play this Bright Seal Protector yet, but it doesn't really matter. So that's my second attack with the misfortune. Do kind of want to strike the Sewanee. But we could potentially have Riposte plus Misfortune to kill an attacking Sewanee.
Bristle, attack.
Well, yeah, so the point of that Elixir of Iron was so it doesn't just die, because the Misfortune trigger, all of their battling enemies take one damage, so they, you know, it was a 2-1, so they didn't want it to die. I'm gonna do this so that if they have like a removal spell, they're using it on my 4-1 and not using it on my misfortune. Cool. Because, you know, now this next turn, if they have removal, I still have the riposte. +4/+4 this round. Ugh, that's annoying.
Love ya.
Return me to the sea.
Just want to make sure I save this misfortune.
Fight for your lives.
It's problematic. I should pull in front of the misfortune, probably. But that still works.
That's why I'm the captain.
Okay, 3-2. These games are definitely pretty interesting. You know, all these new cards and everything, seeing these interactions, definitely a lot of fun. Love this new board. Again, thank you very much to Riot Games for that huge gifted sub party earlier. But yeah, I felt like we needed a little bit more interaction for their champions, or just a couple more spells, I guess, really. Well, I only had 7 spells, so I couldn't really use spell mana very, very often. I liked this Ranger's Resolve. Did see maybe play Riposte, or maybe play Barrier instead of Riposte, but that +3 was really nice. But it is just like giving, like, the different challengers and the different, the challengers were really good, like the Romp Protege, and just the different ways to give, like, the enemy vulnerable. Scout as just a mechanic looked pretty powerful. Being able to attack multiple times in the same turn was definitely really nice, and something I didn't play perfectly, but some of these cards that are underpowered just size-wise, like Greenfang Warden, still felt okay because of Scout. Grizzled Ranger was incredible. Grizzled Rangers was incredible. Island Navigator looked pretty good. Nothing special. That the 2 power, there's a lot of, like, 3 toughness things. The 2 power, you kind of wish it was, like, a third. Like, you wish this was a 3-3 instead of a 2-4. But the 2-4 should help it attack more. Like, it's better as a 2-4 if you have a misfortune in play. But Misfortune looked really, really powerful. This card was awesome. Was not super difficult to level up. And then the level up is just... this is just so difficult. You just can't block anymore. Misfortune looked great. Can the Navigator get a champion? I don't know. You know, it doesn't really specify. I believe the answer is no, that this card cannot get a champion. That's my belief, but I don't know. And we didn't grab any champions, so we haven't seen it get a champion. But Quinn looked a little too easy to kill. That 4 toughness, really wish this had 5 toughness. At 5 mana, wish this was a 3/5. I know it kind of has 5 toughness because you have, you know, 5/5 worth of stats across the 2 bodies because you get the valor. But at this point in the game, by the time you're playing Quinn and then attacking in, it was kind of too difficult to actually attack with Quinn and have Quinn survive at this point of the game. that made that a little difficult. Hired Gun looked good. Liked that card. I could see maybe playing a third Hired Gun and only two Green Fang Warden just to have another two drop, because we did have a lot of times like where we didn't have we didn't really have anything to do until turn three because of all of these cards costing 3, 4, 5, or 6. But all right, there we go. Fun deck. That's our first one. Scout Midrange. Those y'all watching on YouTube later on, leave a comment. Let me know what decks you want to see here on stream with the new set. What are you excited about? If you've been playing some decks, feel free to put the deck code that you're excited about and you want to see on a stream. Put that in a comment. But anyway, let's see. What do you think? Have you looks at the two drop that spawns a keg? Maybe that instead of Hired Gun. I could see doing that also. That card's just fine. Where is it at? Is that in? Oh, right here. There we go. Yeah, Dreadway Deckhand. When I'm summon a powder keg. Yeah, that card's just fine. It is very good with Misfortune. But besides that, it can just kind of clog up your battlefield if you don't have a Misfortune. Because there's not a whole lot of things that are spells and skills to do the extra damage. Like, we only have a couple of things. I think I like the third point of toughness on the Hired Gun and also giving something vulnerable. I think that both of those things are probably better than one Powder Keg. But so, yeah, I like the Hired Gun. Anyway, yep, so there we go. So that's Scout Midrange. Anyway, thanks so much for watching, and I'll see you for the next video.